A diversity of thought is kind of what drives knowledge forward, and it's really having these kind of constructive arguments where you come from different perspectives, you come from different backgrounds, and you kind of work together to chip away at the truth. My research interest originally came from just seeing like the diversity of life and just how things have evolved over time. So the research I currently do on one half is looking at COVID patients, asking why do people get severe COVID? How do we have protective immunity? And what do those cells look like? What are the kind of really tiny molecular changes inside and outside those cells? How they're kind of talking with each other? And the main project right now is looking at these cells that can recognize many of the proteins on SARS-CoV-2. The goal for kind of all this is trying to understand things from the basic biology side and then apply it so we can apply it to patients and create these new therapeutics, be it an actual therapeutic that already exists or some type of insight or advice. So with that was kind of this long COVID problem. And that was looking at patients when they first get COVID. And so things like if they have antibodies that attack themselves, this kind of predisposes you to some symptoms later on. Or something that might be useful is, well, I already have symptoms. I have long COVID. What am I going to do about it? What is with me right now? And one of the things we discovered is this kind of depressed cortisol, which is the stress hormone that you kind of get. This cortisol is also an immunosuppressant. So having lower amounts of it might correlate with increased immunopathology, your immune system causing some damage. And that's one of the therapeutic insights we got from it. I think what really kind of keeps the motivation going is also just the diversity of projects. There's always kind of something new to work on. There's some other perspective to take. I think also it's just in science itself, there's so many different collaborators and other people around. So there's always something, a new tool to apply, a new perspective, or someone disagrees with kind of like the golden law of whatever field we're in. You kind of delve deeper into the tree of knowledge there, and I think that's always really exciting. In research, it really stimulates you to ask kind of why not. You know, I'll start a project, I'll think, okay, we just want to wrap this up, or the story is going to be ABC, and then there's a part D, and there's a part Z, and it just kind of keeps going. I think it's never the story you think it is. It's something that I've kind of learned as I go through this, and I think that's always another part that makes it really exciting, because you're trying to find the story when you have a kind of hypothesis in your mind. You know this hypothesis is probably going to be like very off base, but you kind of figure it out as you go. It's kind of stumbling, walking through the paths. I think it's kind of like a choose your own adventure book. That's really cool.